Hello and welcome to the Birst how-to series. Today I will show you how to create a dashboard.
According to Wikipedia, a dashboard is a type of graphical user interface which often provides at-a-glance views of key performance indicators relevant to a particular objective or business process. They are designed to quickly and clearly communicate information needed to achieve your organizational objectives. In Birst, dashboards have pages with dashlets that hold your visualizer and designer reports. In addition, you can embed filters, add text boxes, KPI widgets, drill across links, images, buttons, and display pages from other websites. Once your space has been created, data imported, and your model built, you can get to dashboards using the module pane on the left. Click on the hamburger menu and you will see the modules you have available. We'll go to dashboards, as planned. When I start creating a dashboard, I see a blank page like this. Before we start populating it, let's change the title of the dashboard. I'll call it Movie Analytics. Once that's done, we start adding dashlets. You can add existing reports slash charts to your dashboard by clicking the circle in the middle. This will take you to the report catalog and show you the folders and reports you have access to. There are private folders and shared folders. Private folders' contents can be seen only by you and the admins in your environment. Let's cancel out of this and go back to the dashboard. The insert menu on top has the option of adding more than just existing reports. I can also add a new report. This takes me to Visualizer where I can start from scratch or open an existing report and modify that. You can also insert a KPI object, an image, an embedded filter, a button, mostly used for moving between dashboards. You can embed a website, and you can use an HTML container to insert a third-party visualization. I'll first add a KPI. The data I'm using here is from Infor Birst Essentials Guide, and you can get the data files and instructions for building the model and reports from the Infor Birst community. There is a link in the description box below the video. So, the KPI. I want the number of movies. I'll search for the measure. I could also browse the semantic layer for the measures available in my model. I start typing movies, and Birst shows me suggestions according to what I type. My model is small, so only movie ID is shown. In the relate video, we talk about making ID columns both an attribute and a measure in Birst. The reason we do this is so that you can do easy calculations on the ID columns, and you can see here how handy that is. I choose the movie ID and then go to choose the appropriate aggregation. All of these are automatically created by Birst, and you can see both count and count distinct in here. I choose count distinct, and that's it. I now have the number of unique movies. You can also use calculations for KPIs. My recommendation is to create them in Visualizer rather than in the KPI. That way you can make the calculation global and have it easily available for both KPIs and Visualizer reports for all users with appropriate user rights. Next, I can choose the date I want to analyze by. Again, my model is small, so I only have one date and hence nothing to choose. I can format the data. Auto is the default value, and it uses the regional settings from user profiles to format the numbers. The None option gives you the number exactly as it is, no formatting. Additionally, you can choose a prefix, the number of decimals, and the currency symbol slash abbreviation. Then we have a couple of style settings. I can change the font and the color of the text. I want to make the actual number and the title black. We use HTML color codes in Birst, but you can just type in the name of a few basic colors. I type black. Then I move on to the title. I change that to No of Movies, and I have to remember to set the slider, otherwise the title won't be shown. I will change the font color in style settings. If at any point you click Save, you're taken back to the dashboard with your KPI. You can always get back to editing by clicking on the KPI, then the edit button, and lastly the button with the pencil icon. The indicator uses conditional formatting. You can use the same measure as before, or another measure. like a comparison to previous month or year for this. I will be looking at my data by year, so I'll create a quick indicator where we get a green hexagon if the number of movies is over 1,000, and change the aggregation to count distinct. Lastly, I can add a microchart to my KPI. This is most useful when you have a time trend for your measure. I'll use quarters for the trend. I'll click on the select attribute, then the default subject area, attribute, time, and finally scroll down to year/quarter. I'll make the chart green using the color dropper functionality. Then it's time to save. This takes us back to the dashboard. When you add objects to the dashboard, they appear in the middle of it and on top of each other, until you move them where you want. You can also let Birst help you by using the dashboard design menu and the layout helper. I'll go with two columns, although at this point it does not really matter as the KPI is the only thing I have. This puts our KPI to the left-hand corner, but I do need to resize the dashlet myself. There are two types of titles in the KPIs. The title of dashlet gets its name from the measure I used, and the KPI title I defined. You can now see both of them. I go to edit, then the eye icon, and use the slider to get rid of the dashlet title. We don't need it. We can now add an existing chart. Go to the insert menu, choose existing report. I have a report about movie genres, and I want to add that, so I will search for it. There's only one with the genre in the title, so I'll pick that. Notice how Birst shows me a preview of the report, so that I can make sure it's the one I want. It is, so I click done. I'll resize my chart a bit and move it under the KPI and click publish. We now have a good start to a dashboard, and in the following videos, we will go into more detail. Thank you for watching.